Significant improvements are coming soon. These developments will come after Flight 11, the highly anticipated mission. However, these advancements aren't limited to the spacecraft. SpaceX will also be implementing major upgrades to its ground facilities, with LP-1 being a key example. Soon, we'll have to say goodbye to the launchpad design and equipment that has played a crucial role in Starship's development over the years. So what modifications is SpaceX making to the launch site, and how will these upgrades impact the future of Starbase? Let's discuss all of this in today's episode of NR Studio. This evolution will not only bring changes to the rocket, but it will also require extensive updates to its supporting infrastructure. The launch pad in particular will need to be transformed to accommodate the next generation of Starship. This is the reason behind the significant redesigns that have taken place recently. Construction of Pad 2 at Starbase has been approached in a completely new way compared to previous years. Similarly, the pad in LC-39A at Cape Canaveral has undergone rapid and significant modifications during its current development phase. These updates clearly indicate a transition to accommodating the future V3 system. Of course, Platform 1 will need to adapt in a similar way soon. The first signs of this shift were evident during the improvements made after the S-38 test. One of the most notable changes was the removal of the damper, which was part of the chopstick mechanism. This damper operates like a spring, helping to reduce the impact and stress on the booster when it lands on the rail. Its primary function is to absorb shock, preventing excessive force from being transmitted through the entire chopstick assembly and reducing the potential for structural damage. With the removal of this component, it was clear that a new phase of development had begun. The removal occurred before Flight 11 because it did not impact this particular mission. For this particular flight, SpaceX would not attempt to recover the booster or spacecraft. Instead, both stages would attempt a sea landing. As a result, the chopstick would only need to perform simpler tasks, such as lifting and securing the vehicle. This allowed SpaceX to begin adjusting the system without disrupting live launch activities. Going forward, this decision would facilitate faster upgrades. According to Musk, the current chopstick design was quite large and difficult to operate, making shortening both arms a top priority. This modification is already visible on Runway 2, where the updated chopsticks appear much more compact and agile. During the latest evaluations, the more compact design has demonstrated significantly enhanced adaptability and responsiveness. Nevertheless, the most crucial improvements will take place within the internal support mechanisms, which encompass the landing rails, stabilizers, and associated mechanical frameworks. It will be essential to rework these elements to fit with the revised Starship V3 layout, especially for the Super Heavy booster. According to preliminary information, Pad 1 is anticipated to focus on capturing the Super Heavy, while Pad 2 will mainly be concentrated on managing the Starship's upper stage. The updated capture system for Super Heavy will also undergo changes. Rather than the separate catching points utilized in the current iteration, the upcoming model will feature the catching points embedded directly under the grid fence. This adjustment in structure will facilitate a more robust and controlled capture, enhancing both efficiency and safety. Below the launch tower, even more extensive modifications are anticipated. The present six-legged orbital launch mount, referred to as the OOLM, will be fully taken apart. The steel water-cooled plate, sometimes known as the inverted shower, which has been crucial in shielding the pad during test launches, will also be eliminated. While these systems have been beneficial to SpaceX, their removal will create space for an entirely new launch framework engineered for increased power and durability. SpaceX will substitute the outdated systems of Pad 1 with a complete flame trench designed to handle the severe exhaust from upcoming Starship launches. This trench will be dug out near the tower, constructed with concrete, equipped with flame buckets, and connected to the cooling and plumbing systems. Following this, engineers will erect upper structures, which will include a new platform for the OOLM and a booster QD gantry intended for fueling and operational control. A new OOLM, now being put together at the Sanchez facility, is designed to have a box shape similar to that of Pad 2 and will be set on the new base once it is completed. In contrast to Pad 2, Pad 1 already possesses a tower, enabling SpaceX to initiate construction from the lower sections and speed up development. Owing to enhanced techniques and accumulated experience, the entire transformation could be accomplished within a year, potentially by the middle of next year, with test operations commencing in the third quarter. Improvements to the chopsticks, being more straightforward, might be ready sooner for mid-air capture experiments between flights 13 and 15. Once finished, little of the original Pad 1 might remain, but its legacy will persist. Since the SN8 campaign in 2020, it has been instrumental in every significant event of Starship's progress. As SpaceX transitions to the V3 system and achieves full reusability, Pad 1 must also transform, representing both an enhancement and a farewell to a significant chapter. To commemorate Pad 1's journey, please comment on keeping the upgrades flowing below and ensure you follow us as we continue to report on SpaceX's ambitious quest for the future of space exploration.
Now, I must state that if Pad 1 marked the transition between two phases of Starship development, then Pad 2 emerges as the harbinger of a new era. This location reflects SpaceX's continued progress, building on previous experience but fully geared toward facilitating the next generation of Starship spacecraft. In mid and late September, SpaceX conducted several crucial evaluations of the water deluge system integrated into the Pad 2 fire trench. These evaluations demonstrated the system's capacity to handle the substantial exhaust output of Starship's 33 Raptor engines. However, this is only the beginning. In preparation for the more robust static fire test involving real boosters, further installation and system assessments remain. Since early September, the SpaceX team has been tirelessly engaged in the installation and testing of the stabilizer arms located on either side of the booster's suction cup. These arms are vital to maintaining the stability of this colossal spacecraft during liftoff and capture. Once these elements were installed, engineers began performance evaluations under various load scenarios to ensure their ability to safely manage the overall weight and dimensions of the Starship B3 prototype. Next, the focus shifted to the lower pad area where cladding panels were installed around the QD booster gantry. These panels serve to encase the QD structure, increasing its durability and offering better protection against debris and heat generated during launch. SpaceX appears to have chosen to install the panels only after the QD system was adequately installed, ensuring mechanical and visual coherence throughout the structure. Despite this progress, much installation and testing remains unfinished. SpaceX appears to be progressing systematically, coordinating construction efforts with system validation. Many analysts predict that Flight 12, the inaugural mission using the Starship V3 prototype, may occur later this year. However, there is growing speculation that this mission could be extended into early next year, depending on the pace of testing and certification. Regardless, the timeline between late 2025 and early 2026 is expected to remain relatively stable. This suggests that SpaceX is likely aiming to complete all significant testing on Pad 2 in October and November. Two key elements will be the focus during this phase: the blowpipe mechanism and the OLM and fire trench complex. Regarding the blowpipe, upcoming testing will focus on stability, precision, and lift capacity, particularly after the new stabilizer arms are installed. This evaluation will determine whether the system is ready to attempt to capture a Starship stage in midair, a feat expected to be tested between the 13th and 15th flights. Meanwhile, the OLM and fire trench will undergo a series of static fire evaluations. These will represent some of the most crucial steps before Pad 2 becomes fully operational. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next time.